Right, in this example, we look at a future value problem from the perspective of the formulas and the spreadsheet. So when we're talking about the formulas in this problem, we need to identify which of the problems that we are looking at. We need to determine if we are the problem that as stated, is this problem a compound interest problem? AKA a lump sum problem? Is this an ordinary annuity problem? Or is this a loan problem? Okay, and we will try to figure that out as we read. So what we have is a person that is trying to put money into an account, and they're making deposits of $140 at the end of 6 months for 7 years' time. And they're paying into an account that is 5.6% compounded semi-annually. And because we're making regular deposits, we know that this account is a special type of an account called an annuity. And we are looking for how much we are going to have, find the amount in that account, and you might want to say after seven years of time. And this after 7 years of time is in the future. So we're doing a future value problem, but is it a problem that is also an ordinary annuity problem? Having identified what kind of problem we're looking at, we know that the ordinary annuity equation tells us that the amount in an account depends on the amount that you start with that accrues interest. Okay? And then we make regular deposits or payments into the account, and that will be multiplied by 1 plus r over n to the nt minus 1 divided by r over n. And we've talked in previous videos how to, I'm sorry, maybe we should call this instead of P0, let's call this the initial amount in the account. We've talked about this formula in the past. It might be best to think about this as A0 multiplied by some number, where this number is that number 1. And then we're going to add on to that R multiplied by some other number. And that is what this complicated number is. That we'll call that number 2. And that is the amount in an account at any time. Okay? So if we look at what information we have in this problem and we want to go through the formulas route, we were making payments into an account. That's the R value of $140 at the end of each of 6 months. So we are on a compounding of interest scale 2, right? Our time is for 7 years' time. Our A0 amount, evidently, we're not starting with any money in the account. We are just making deposits into it, and we didn't actually start with any money. Okay, let me see. We have an interest rate, an APR, an annual percentage rate of 5.6%. So that is 0.056. That's the R value. And what turns out to be important is the R over N value. This is the interest rate per period. This is 0.056 divided by 2. This is called the interest rate per period. And the periods here are every 6 months. Okay? So what we can do here is we're familiar with the formulas. We know that since A0 is equal to 0, the amount in the account after 7 years' time is just going to be the number of the payments that we're making of $140 multiplied by number 2. And so we simply would need to go over to Desmos and do a calculation here. Let me minimize that. And we could go to Desmos and we could say that number 2. Well, first of all, number 1, which we've typically done, is 1 plus interest rate per period, 0.056 divided by 2. Raise this to the n, which is 2 times 7 years. So in 7 years, we make 14 payments. And if we want our n2 value, that's going to be equal to We can see our in the number, second number is also in 1 minus 1 divided by r over n. So n 1 minus 1. Let's divide that by the interest rate per period, 0.056 divided by 2. So there's our N2 value. And so if we want to know the amount in the account after 7 years, we simply need to take the $140 R and multiply that by the N2 amount. This formula right here is what we have done right here in Desmos. So this tells me that the amount that we're going to have in the account is going to be equal to, after 7 years, $2,359.93. Okay? And that's us using the formulas to compute the amount. Okay? There's also a way to compute the future value of an annuity using a spreadsheet tool, right? And that's what I would like to demonstrate next. And just like to realize that we should get this number 2359.93. So I'm going to go to my favorite spreadsheet tool. That's the one that's easiest for you to find, okay? And that spreadsheet tool could be like Google Sheets, for example. So in Google Sheets, if you go in and type a formula and then you say FV for future value, right, and look at the little help window that comes up, we can see that what we need to do here is put the rate, the interest rate. Now this is the interest rate per period. This is not the 5.6%. The interest rate per period is 0.056 divided by 2. 0.056 divided by 2. That's the interest rate per period. Now, if you do a comma, you can see that the computer is helping us go to the next step. We need the number of periods. So let's fill that in. The number of periods is, there were 2 periods per year, but we were doing this money depositing for seven years. So the number of periods is, N is the number of periods. The number of periods is the N value times the time. So in this case, it'd be 2 times 7, which is equal to 14. Okay? And then we need to move on, comma. We need to move on to the payment amount. You can see that the computer is walking us through. The next comma is the payment amount. We're paying $140 out of our pocket. And then, let me see, the next value is the present value. The present value is how much did we start with in the account, and this person did not start with any money in the account. And let me see, we want to do the end beginning problem. We want to make our payments at the end of the month. And there you can see the number that appears, right? 2359.93. That's the value that if you hit enter, you will get the future value of this annuity, 2359.93. Okay? The reason the computer is saying it's negative is because you had to, you know, come up with this money, $140, out of your pocket. So that was money out of your pocket. So that's why the minus sign was there. But that money that was out of your pocket went into the annuity. So 2359.93 is the amount of money in the account. Okay? So ends this video on doing the future value of an annuity with the formulas and with the FV expression in Google Sheets. And as you cycle through these different, what you're supposed to put, you're getting a reminder about what each of these numbers is supposed to be. The important one here, well, they're all important, but the one that might cause a little bit of, just to be careful about, is the rate. The interest rate is the interest rate per period. So that is important to put the interest rate per period, 0.056 divided by 2. So ends this video.